Hello everyone, Ranjita here. Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm here with some quick, easy and fun ideas of cards that you can make for this Father's Day. This video is dedicated to all those lovely, adorable and superhero stunned fathers. Without you guys, we would have been nothing. Thank you for holding on to us and being our strength. Before we move on further, kindly consider subscribing to my channel. So let's get started. For making these cards, you do not require any high-end fancy supplies. All I'm using is some basic watercolors, 2 cups of water, 1 plain and 1 to wash my brushes in. And I'm using a flat brush, a round brush and a very very thin brush to do detailing. So let's move on and go ahead and do the first card. For the first card, I've taken some 300 GSM watercolor paper and I've taped it down onto my table. I've roughly made a circle. I've just used a lid here to draw my outline of a circle. And now what I'm doing is layering it with a thin coat of water. Once I've layered it down with a thin coat of water, I'm taking a shade of green and I'm roughly trying to draw a world map here. Please don't judge my skills. I'm just doing a basic outline of map. This is no way intended to replicate the original world map. So I'm just drawing rough outlines representing the different continents and a little water body here and there. So just to give you a general idea, I'm just making a world map here. So first I'm going with a lighter shade of green. For this, I'm using the wet on wet technique because I didn't want the lines to be very sharp and evident. So I've layered my circle with a thin layer of water first, and then I'm just lightly coloring it with green. As you can see, since I've already layered it with water, the paint is just flowing into the areas where I've applied it. It gives a very different texture to the painting. As you can see, I'm going ahead with different shades of green just to add some texture here and there. Once I'm happy doing my continents, I will go ahead and fill the empty spaces with different shades of blue. This will be representing my ocean waters. So as you can see, very very simple and easy way of painting a globe. All I did is made a sphere outline, a circular outline, coated it with a thin layer of water and then added my green and blue areas. Once I'm done painting my globe and now going ahead and making a rough outline for the stand on which the globe is standing, and then after making a rough outline with a pencil, I will be shading it with different shades of brown. I'm using the same wet on wet principle again. I'm just outlining the shape with plain water first and then filling in with different shades of brown here. As you can see, I'm not doing any perfect drawing here, just filling in the shapes so that it gives a look of a globe. I'm now almost done painting my globe. I'm now peeling off the tape that I've used to adhere the paper flat, and then I will be doing some basic lettering or adding a little sentiment onto this card. I've layered this watercolor sheet onto black cardstock and then onto a folded card base, and now I'm writing out the sentiment. It says, "You mean the world to me." I thought it is a very apt sentiment for a Father's Day card. You can see the close-up image here. Moving on to the second card, I'm making a rough outline of a baby bear and a papa bear. You do not have to be a great artist to make these cards. I'm a watercolor beginner artist as well. All that matters is the intention and the thought behind making these cards. So I decided to share these simple examples that are very kid friendly, and even little ones can replicate or do something similar for their fathers on this Father's Day. So as you can see here, I'm making a rough very rough pencil outline. Make sure your pencil lines are not very harsh, because later it becomes very difficult if they get trapped under the watercolor. It'll be very difficult to erase these pencil lines. So I'm just giving a very, very rough outline of a little bear and a papa bear. Once I'm done giving an outline, I'm filling these outlines with a lighter shade of brown. First, I'm going with an even coat of lighter shade of brown. Make sure your paint is very runny and not a thick layer, because that way, if the paint is very loose and runny, the watercolors give their own texture on their own. So this is what I'm trying to do. I'm just dabbing very, very liquidy watercolors, if you can understand what I mean. So it itself gives a texture, and you do not have to do too much to the painting. I'm going ahead and filling in the father bear also with a lighter shade of brown. All I'm doing is I'm making sure my colors are very runny, and so that they do not form any harsh lines or very evident borders. I'm just dabbing in very liquidy watercolors onto an already wet surface. This itself is giving a unique texture to the bear, so you do not have to struggle much to add a lot of texture to it. I'm not a great watercolor expert, but I think little techniques and tips like this will make your paintings look much more realistic. As you can see, I'm just playing around with lighter and darker shades of brown. Once my initial coat of lighter shade of brown has dried, I'm going ahead and adding some more darker tones here and there, just to give it a more realistic look. And if you have any doubt, you can always have a reference image from Google to know where to place the darker shades and where to place the lighter shades. Bears are one of my favorite animals. I feel they represent a lot of coziness and warmth around. So I thought this little bear and father bear combination would be a perfect way to let your fathers know how warm and protected you feel with them around. So I'm, as you can see here in the painting, just adding little details here and there. Make sure you give enough time for each layer to dry before you apply another layer, so that it's easily mendable. I really liked how this was turning out. Just playing around with different shades of brown brought in so much texture to these bears. To add some more texture and to cover up my little flaws, if at all they were, I'm adding some splatters here and there. First, I'm using a toothbrush to add some splatters. All you need to do is dilute the paint and then dip in your toothbrush into it and add splatters all over the card. I wanted some more bigger splatters, so I went ahead with my brush as well. This is a very easy way to add some background and to add some more interest to your card. Now that all my painting is dry, I'm going ahead and peeling off this tape. Here is my finished watercolor painting of a little bear holding his hand with its father. Now I'm going ahead and taking a fine liner pen. Make sure this is waterproof, or make sure if it is not waterproof, you add these details once your painting is entirely dry. So I'm just adding a small snout here with my black pen. For my sentiment, I'm first roughly lettering it down with pencil, and then I'm trying to do some faux calligraphy here. I'm writing down the words Papa Bear. Once I write it down, I am then going ahead and thickening the strokes. So as you know, in calligraphy, your down strokes are thick and your upward strokes are thin. So I'm first writing it down normally, and then I'm going ahead and thickening all those down strokes. This is a very, very easy way to give a brush lettering effect to your writing. All you need to do is write it down normally first, and then thicken all the downward strokes. This will give a faux calligraphy look, and it will give a lot of more beauty. It will add more beauty to your writing. Going ahead and writing down the word best also in a similar way. First writing it down normally, and then I am thickening all the downward strokes. All you need is some watercolors and a fine liner pen to finish this cute and simple card. Here is my finished card. I loved how these splatters were adding so much texture. You can see the close-up of the finished card here. Moving on to the third card, I'm making a rough outline of a heart shape here. For this card, I'm going to paint a little galaxy here, or a galaxy-like image. Galaxies are very, very fun and easy to paint, and you can add so much more interest and brightness to your galaxies. And the best part is, you do not have a right way or wrong way of doing it. You can have galaxies in different shades or different color combinations. As you can see here, I'm going ahead with my wet on wet technique again. I've made an outline of a heart with a pencil first. Make sure your pencil lines are very, very light, because later it becomes extremely difficult to erase them. You might end up ruining your painting if your pencil lines are very harsh, as they get trapped under the watercolor. Next, I'm going ahead and adding different colors. The brighter the colors, the brighter your galaxy ends up looking. So first, I'm using different shades of blue, violets and reds here. I've painted my heart with a thin coat of water first, and then just I'm dropping my paint onto it and letting it flow on its own. Since I've already painted a thin layer of water, the paint doesn't seep outside the area where you haven't painted water. That is, the paint flows within your outline itself. For that reason, I'm very comfortable with wet on wet technique compared to dry technique. So I am just playing around with different shades of blue, reds and violets here. Once you are done with a little thin layer of shades, you can let this layer dry and then again go ahead and add in more color and make your galaxy as brighter as you want it to be. You can go ahead and play with whatever colors you like I have done here. I am using blues, reds and purples here. Or else you can always take inspiration from Google and check out the different color combinations of different galaxies and then try to mimic them. The trick here is, you need to have very wet, runny paint so that your colors merge well. Once my painting is still wet, I'm taking a earbud and just pulling off some paint from the paper here. I will tell you why I did this. Now I'm going ahead with a very, very thin diluted layer of black everywhere, just to remove all those harsh, in case if my colors haven't blended well, this black will bring everything together. But make sure your black is very, very runny or diluted, because if you have a thicker black, then it'll be covering the layers underneath. So I'm just outlining my heart well and adding a little diluted black here and there. Once this is still wet, I'm again going ahead with my earbud, and I will dab off or remove some paint here and there. This will later turn out to look like the halos around my stars, and it gives a very unique and 3D effect to my painting. Now I am happy and done with my galaxy painting. I have mixed some white acrylic paint in a very dilute manner and then dipping in my toothbrush onto it and adding splatters all over this galaxy. This will make them look like stars. I use a toothbrush initially because you get very thin splatters with a toothbrush and you also have more control over it. Once I'm happy with my little stars, I'm going ahead and taking a white gel pen and adding some more brighter and bigger stars here and there. As you can see, I'm placing these stars also on the areas that I have removed a little paint with the earbud. The paint that we have removed with the earbud gives an effect of a halo around the stars and gives a lot of more interest to your galaxy. Now that I am happy with my painting, I am just peeling off my paper. Now I have made a card base ready and I am placing my heart on this galaxy on this. I could not record the remaining part of the card, but here you can see the finished card. I have added some lettering to it. So these are the three cards that we've done today with just using a fine liner pen and some humble watercolors. I hope you will definitely give these cards a try and you liked my little inspiration on Father's Day cards here. Each card is unique in its own way, but all I used was some simple watercolors, a pencil to make my outlines and a fine liner pen. I'm sure you have all these supplies lying around your house and you will definitely give these inspirations a try for this Father's Day. You can see the close-up images of the finished cards here. I really liked how simple and easy they were to make. And I also liked my way of experimenting with watercolors. I hope you like these cards also. If you do make something similar, make sure you share them with me on my social media channels. I would love to see what you make. This was my take for this Father's Day. I hope you liked it. I will come back soon with another interesting technique video and inspiration for you. Thank you so much for stopping by. Also, if you haven't done it yet, kindly consider subscribing to my channel and tap on the bell icon so that you get notified every time I post a new video. Also, do follow me on my social media where I share my craft and card making photos and inspiration with you. The links are given in the description box below. Thank you.